What's happening? What's up? What's good? And what to do? I just want to talk to you about everything is love and all for love. Everything is love. Look for love in everything. Time is very critical right now. We're running out of time, and I mean that on a lot of different levels. We're running out of time. Time is moving so fast. Maybe it's not for you, but most of the people that I encounter, whether it's watching other videos and healers or people that I talk to, even the kids, I don't know if the kids are just repeating what they heard or if they really feel like time is just moving really, really fast. And we're running out of time. If you notice, towers are just falling and falling. And it's so much happening. I have lost or been to, I've been to at least 14 funerals since the beginning of this year. People that I know are passing in 20s. There used to be where people were passing in threes. I was thinking, I was like, oh, they go in threes. They're going in 20s now. Then if you look at celebrities or whatever, I don't have a full understanding of what's happening and why so many people are passing. I've been trying to find time to get answers to that, but so much is happening so fast, I don't really get a chance to wrap my mind fully around it. But I do notice when God in the universe is speaking to me and drawing my attention to something, and I grab it in that moment, but I don't always get time to hold on to it. Again, as I tell you, always, I have so much going on. Everything is going to come to fruition, but you know what I'm really grateful for is that it's not just one person and one way for anything to happen. Look at how eclectic and big this world is. There's no one size that fits all with anything. So if I can just bring any pearls, if I can put any sunshine on some information that you already have, if I can bring any love, joy, or peace, or click something in you, then I've done what I'm supposed to do. And I think that's what it's all about. So I have some different cards I want to pull tonight that I've been attracted to, and I want to just pull some energy. This is an ancestor deck, I guess I can call it. So I just want to say, or ask, God is ancestor spirit, guys. I just want to know energy from my loved ones that have transcended to true home, that are on the other side. Is there a message or is there a word that we should know that's going to bless somebody's heart, somebody's mind? It's going to be some comfort. That's going to be love. Because it's all about love. It's all about love. It's more important now to love than ever. Oh, God, I hate when this happens. These cards have failed, so that means in the month. I don't hate when it happens. I mean to say that. You're the more power advocate. So I'm always working on myself. So I didn't mean to say I hate that. It's just going to be curious what this card is. Is it just one? Yep. Pardon me. Excuse me. What's the word? What's the word? What's the word? What's the word? We are soulmates. So, if there's somebody that you lost, that's a soulmate. You know, this is confirmation that we are soulmates. That we are never apart. Love never dies. That they just transcended, but we're soulmates, and that we're always connected in spirit. Always connected in spirit. And this is personal for me because, like I said, I've lost so many people that are close to me. Then the anniversary of people that I've lost before. The love never dies, and it's so important. And I have just, you know, posted a memorial today to someone that passed, and I said that I didn't use the word we are soulmates, but maybe I did. I have to go back and look at the post. But that we are connected. Our souls are together. We are twin souls. We're never separated. Just because she is on the other side, it does not mean that we're not together. So hopefully that resonates with you. If there's someone that you love that's on the other side, that the message is that they're your soulmate and they're still with you. The spirit never dies. Love never dies. Spirit never dies. It's always with you. They're always with you. And they got the best seat in the house. So guard your mind, your thoughts. Love is everything. Be loving. Be loving. Be loving. Be grateful. Be loving. Be grateful. If you had a coin and you put that coin on one side, you'd be loving. On the other side, be grateful. Man, you will be unstoppable. Get you a coin. One side grateful, one side loving. Power of love. What's the message regarding the power of love? What's the message regarding the power of love? Message for the power of love. Commitment. You dedicate yourself to your beliefs wholeheartedly, knowing that love is the essence of your very being. Commitment. You dedicate yourself to your beliefs wholeheartedly, knowing that love is the essence of your very being. Confirmation. It's all about love. The four agreements. The Four Agreements book I used to use when I used to teach self-empowerment is to be impeccable with your word. Don't take anything personally. Don't make assumptions and always do your best. What's the message from the Four Agreements when it's all about love? It's all about love. It's all about love. Line at a time. The most important thing that you can do for yourself or anybody is to remember it's all about love. It's all about love. It's all about love. A coin. One side gratitude, the other side love. Always act with love. Always feel and operate from gratitude. Love and gratitude. Love and gratitude. These cards are tight. We'll do one more shuffle. All for love. What's the message? All for love, baby. All for love. All about love. All about love. Don't make assumptions. Learn to ask questions. So instead of being judgmental, instead of getting in people's business, instead of making things personal, don't make assumptions. Learn to ask questions. It is always better to ask questions than to make assumptions. Have the courage to ask questions until you are as clear as you can be. Once you can hear the answer to a question, you won't have to make assumptions because you will know the truth. So you can be loving and so you can be grateful. So many relationships have been lost, altered, broken, damaged because people made assumptions. They heard something and took it as gospel and ran with it. I try to stop that every chance I get, letting people gossip or pour their assumptions off on me. I stop it. I shut it down. I correct them when I can, or just say, yeah, I don't believe that to be true. And if you don't know if that's true for sure, why are you repeating something like that? You are adding to the problems, of the relationship building across the board for everybody. And then the other side of that is the way that you ask questions. There are people that can ask questions that will just offend you. The tone of their voice, because they're asking from a place that is not love. They're asking with the mask of understanding, but they're asking the question with the tone and the intention to clarify a judgment that they have against you. And then they are shocked if you don't feel the misconception or the judgment or the opinion that they have of you. You have ran into people like this. If you haven't, notice how someone would ask you a question in a way that just sounds so condescending. It's like they're saying it just to kind of trap you into their toxicity. And they operate like that. And a lot of times they are, I'm just going to put it out there, they're Christians in the name of Jesus. I have not heard, I just had a conversation with my cousin today. She said that Beyonce released a song called Church Girl or something like that. And she's going to task on, they call them Sunday morning Christians, but they're only Christians on Sunday morning, whatever. And this can relate to any religion, but I'm just picking on Christianity for a lot of different reasons. One, that's the way I was introduced to God. And two, because it's so much hypocrisy. And three, because in my experience, they tend to be the most judgmental people. And I'm not saying this about all Christians or all Christian churches or all Christian situations, but the vast majority of the Christians that I have interacted with in my life have all been very judgmental and love to tell somebody where they're going. The other side of that is they don't know how to live and let live. You got to fit in their box. And again, that goes with the conscious community as well. And I'm picking on, I'm honestly saying I'm picking on the Christians because it's easy for me to do. No one has ever hurt me or mistreated me or abused me in my whole life. Not one of them wasn't a Christian. They was, every one of them was a Jesus-pumping Christian. No disrespect. It's all about love. It's all about gratitude. I'm grateful for those experiences. Holy sticks. I'm grateful for those experiences. And I appreciate and love those people regardless of what has happened. I don't deal with all of them. I cut people out for my sanity and so that I can prosper on every level. They had to go. I'm going to pray for you. No, don't pray for me. I don't want you to do nothing for me. You don't see yourself in the mirror as you really are. So I don't want you to do nothing for me. Go somewhere and be the best you can be. Now for this, I'm going to take a top and a bottom on this one. It's all about love and gratitude. We're running out of time. 2022 has all been all about exposing powers, exposing people and situations. Okay. It's all about love. Taking the top one and the bottom one. Okay. I'm going to take this one too. Okay, let me do them in order. First one, it's all about love. It's all about love and gratitude. What do I resist feeling right now? Soul truth. We have to feel it to heal it. In order to let go of pain, we first have to honor its existence. Emotions are like waves. Some are soft, some are fierce. Some are layered and some will sweep you off your feet. When we allow ourselves to feel it, we can then release what no longer serves us. Today's soul action, allow yourself to feel this wave. Let it move through you, no matter how long it lasts. Then release it back into the ocean. Feel it. Heal it. Enjoy the sweet freedom within your soul. Man, I hope this helps somebody. Man, I hope this helps somebody. Am I communicating my needs? Your needs matter. what you are needing right now that you haven't communicated, what are you afraid of? Is it possible that you are fearing it's not true? I did a video on my health. Well, I'll speak a little bit about my health, but recently I was talking about the color blue and the negative aspects of closing your throat chakra or the low frequency of your throat chakra and your needs mattering, and am I communicating my needs, and is it possible that you're fearing, is it possible that what you are fearing is not true? So in the guise of a job, are you thinking that this is a job for you, this job you're supposed to have? Is it possible that what you're fearing is not true? You're not speaking up because you find out that this isn't what you thought it was. Is it possible that what you are fearing is not true? The other side of that is the truth about the whole matter. Are you afraid that it's not true? Are you afraid that the whole person, the whole shebang, the whole setup is something that's not true? So you are not communicating because you don't want to unask the truth and deal with the truth. You want to live with the lie. One of my favorite tattoos from one of my biological relatives is most people demand to be lied to. So the action for this, what are my needs? Am I saying no and yes enough based on my desires? Am I telling my full truth? Do I believe that my needs matter? And do I share them with others? Do I ask for what I want when communicating my needs? What am I resisting and with whom? What do I need in order to feel safe enough to express my needs? What do I need to feel safe enough to express my needs? Is somebody holding something financially over your head that you can't speak up because it's a work situation, and if you speak up for your needs, you're not heard? Think about it. Whatever's true to you, where can I make a difference in my personal life, my personal actions, what I do and how I show up for myself and other people? What can I do to make a difference? Soul truth. What keeps you up at night? I hope nothing, darling. If it is something that you need to be dealing with, at least don't let it keep you up at night, because then it'll be extra agitated the next day. You'll be drained on top of dealing with the thought of everything. Do what you gotta do to get over that. What makes you cringe when you think about it? Such that every ounce of you screams no more. Gosh. Where can you create purpose out of your pain? Make a difference in someone's life today, big or small, because all of it makes a difference. Well, if that resonates with you, I hope that it helps you. Where can you create purpose out of pain? I hope, no matter what you're going through, I hope that somehow the love comforts you, and that you can create purpose out of that pain. And it's hard to say when we're talking about losing someone. And, you know, it doesn't matter how you perceive death as a transition or whatever. The bottom line is you want to keep those people close to you. That's natural. And to find purpose in that pain is not easy. It's not easy. And I hope that, I know that if you tune in to God, Goddess, ancestors, and spirit guides, that it's going to be something to comfort you. And I'm not talking about drugs or alcohol or becoming a cultish about anything. I just mean in your day-to-day existence, as you move through each day, that God's going to put people in places that cross your path that would allow you to show up and make a difference for you and make a difference for somebody else, where you will feel comforted on your path, that you will find something that will keep you from staying up late at night, that you will find some comfort that will let you let it go, sleep in peace. Whether it's write down your thoughts in a journal before you go to bed and leaving them on your altar, or writing down on a piece of paper and sitting it outside in the moonlight. Something. I know this might sound weird. A lot of my friends that are, I don't know, still teetering with Christianity or whatever, or are only interested in one side of having a relationship with God. When you say something about any aspect of nature and how it could possibly heal you or bring comfort to you, they tune out. But I hope that you're able to tune into anything. If reading those scriptures will give you comfort so you can lay it down, there's some beautiful things in the Bible. And I hope that you can do that. If it's the Quran or whatever it is, you can find some words in one of your favorite books or a Hallmark card that someone gave you. Not to throw any advertising out for Hallmark, but any card or note that someone gave you that just bless your heart, especially if you know you are dealing with the loss of a loved one. Any of those messages that this hold dear to your heart, that you can put your burden down, take it. If it's something that makes you cringe, write that down. What is it and why is it making you cringe, and what can you do about it? Is there any type of animation that you can do about it? Speak it out loud. This makes me cringe and I want it to stop making me cringe, or this makes me cringe and this is what I need to do about that. Help me on my path. Help me on my path to get over this. I used to be a germaphobe. I've gotten much better. And thank God I got better before COVID. I don't know. I probably would have been a wreck. But I was so happy during the shutdown. I was just like, yes. If every ounce of you is screaming no more and you're having a hard time finding purpose with your pain, seek some help. If you cannot find it in nature and through the comfort of people that you know or your own spiritual practices, reach out to someone and get some help. Someone that's, you know, a certified professional in dealing with that. And I earnestly hope that you find somebody that's good and somebody that's not a predator or someone that's just there for a check, or they're stuck in their own head about something and not able to actually help you. A lot of the people that I know that have gone through counseling have met people that were just milking their financial, milking their insurance. They weren't really helping them. So I pray that you get comfort on your guidance and that you find something in somebody inside of yourself as well as external on the path that can help you be full of love and gratitude, because we're running out of time. And until next time, remember, it's all about love, and I love you and I'm wishing you the best. Share your experiences with me. Drop a comment. Until real soon, love, peace, and blessings.